Good morning, students. In previous lecture, we have discussed about Mughal rulers, their military campaign. Today, we are going to discuss the next topic. It is Mughal tradition of succession. Mughal tradition of succession. After one emperor who become the ruler of entire empire, the empire was distributed among the son of emperor. The territory of kingdom was distributed among all sons of the Mughal emperor. From Babur it was started. The son of Babur, Humayun, he was distributed his territory among all brothers. This was the tradition of the Mughal succession. Mughal were distributing their kingdom among all sons. Not the eldest son was the emperor or king. It was distributed equally among them. Now the next topic is Mughal relation with other rulers. We are going to discuss it. Mughal relation with other rulers, this is the topic. When Mughal became powerful, many Rajput rulers, they came under the Mughals. They accepted the authority of Mughals. About them, campaigned constantly against ruler who refused to accept their authority. Mughal emperor, they started attacking on those ruler who are opposing the Mughals, those were not accepting the supremacy of Mughal rule. Mughal ruler attacked on them. Then, other than military command, Mughals also had some diplomatic strategies for expansion. Mughals, they had done many treaties with Rajputs. They do not want to fight and lose their military. That is why they adopted some diplomatic condition for their rule. Other than military campaign, Mughals also had some diplomatic strategies for expansion. Then, as Mughal became powerful, at that time, many rulers were there who accepted the supremacy of Mughals. Mughal and Rajput ties were there, and then many Rajputs were there who had given their daughters in marriage to them. For example, the mother of Jahangir was Kachhawa princess, daughter of Rajput ruler of Amber, which is in present time Jaipur. The mother of Shah Jahan was Rathor princess, daughter of the Rajput ruler of Marwad, Jodhpur. In this way they adopted many type of way to rule peacefully. And many rulers were there who resisted. For example, Maharana Pratap and the Sisodia Rajputs, they do not accepted the supremacy of Mughal started campaign against them. They started military attack on them, and after gaining the victory, after victory, they returned their land to them. They returned their kingdom to them respectfully. In this way, this respect was created, nice relationship between the Mughal emperor, but every Mughal emperor was not so good. Akbar, Jahangir, they were adopted this type of method. They had attacked on many Rajput kings and they defeated the Rajput, but they returned their territory, they returned their kingdoms to them respectfully. In this way, very nice relationship was created between Mughal emperor and Rajput rulers, but many other Mughal rulers were there who were not doing the same thing with other ruler, like Aurangzeb. He was very cruel. Shivaji, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, who was Maratha ruler, when he went to Aurangzeb's court, he insulted them and he put them in jail. Then Maharaja Shivaji Maharaj, he revolted against Aurangzeb and he stabilized his Maratha kingdom in Maharashtra. Next topic which we are going to discuss, it is Mansabdars and Jagirdars. Now the topic is Mansabdars and Jagirdars. At first we have to understand the background. In the beginning, when Mughal Empire was established by Babur, at that time it was too small. He was the ruler of Farghana, and when he captured Delhi and some kingdoms of surrounding area, that area was very small and it was administered easily. But when the area was expanded, there was a requirement of many officials. For that, they started recruitment of new officers for their court. From the small nucleus of Turkish nobles, Turanis, they expanded to include Iranians, Indians, Muslims, Rajputs, Afghans, Maratha and other groups. When they expanded their territories and different type of people were there, different type of chieftains were there, they were recruited
as a mansabdar. Here, who is mansabdar? Those who joined Mughal services, who started working in Mughal court or Mughal emperor, they are called mansabdars. And here two things is given in the topic mansabdars and jagirdars. Mansabdars were the person who had their ranks, and their ranks were given to them according to their work, and they had their savar, their cleverly, they had to maintain their military, the savars. When the emperor asked them to come and fight any war, at that time they have to maintain the cavalry, the savars, the horsemen who fight in the war, and also they collect revenue. Some areas are given to them as a jagir. From that jagir, jagirdari was collected by their servants. The mansabdars, they serve at any part of the Mughal empire, they serve anywhere, but the revenue was collected by their servants. The jagirdari was collected by their servants. It was like ikta, but iktakdar was living in that area, which we have discussed in previous lecture. Ikta and iktakdar or mukti were living in that place, and they were collecting the taxes, and they were the mostly slave of the rulers. But here mansabdars, they belong to many other rulers. They may be Rajput, and they may be Afghanis, Iranians. The mansabdari was given to them. The revenue collected by their servants were given to the emperor, or salary also given to the mansabdars. Like Man Singh was the mansabdar in the court of Akbar, whose jat was 5,000. And at the time of Aurangzeb, his brother Dara Sukho was also mansabdar, whose rank was given. Jat is the rank which is given to the mansabdar. Dara Sukho's jat was 40,000, and he became too much powerful at the time of Aurangzeb, and he was revolted against Aurangzeb, and Aurangzeb killed him because he was becoming powerful. And in this way, Japt was the position of the mansabdars. It saw the position of the mansabdar. Mansabdar had to maintain the cleverly, and cleverly system or savar was there who fight the war when required. To know the number of cleverly, the rank was given to the mansabdar according to their savars, and also stamping system was there with burning equipment. The horses were given sign to find out to which mansabdar the horses are belonging, because many mansabdars were there. In this way, mansabdars were the most important people at the time of Akbar up to Aurangzeb, they play very important role in the war. Now, next topic is Japt and Jamindar. Japt, the main source of income available to the Mughal rulers was tax on the produce of peasantry. At that time, when Mughals were ruling, the main occupation of the people was peasantry farming, and they collect tax from the peasants. And many jamindars were there who take the revenue from the farmers, mostly the chieftain of the villages were known as Jamindar. Akbar's revenue minister Todarmal carried out careful survey of crop yields, the crop produced by the farmers, and their prices were taken in mind, and in this way, on this, that product, the Japt was taken, the revenue was taken. Each province was divided into revenue circles with its own schedule of revenue rates for individual crops. This revenue system was known as Japt. As I previously told you, Japt is a revenue taken by the Jamindars. Then after it was provided to the Mughal emperor for maintaining their court, for maintaining their army. It was taken from the peasants.